You gotta get like mad close because it's a wide angle.
Yeah, I got you.
How's the new lens looking? Hold on, there's some shit on it. I got it. Does it look clean?
Yeah, it looks fucking dope.
HD gains?
Oh, you already know.
Alright, so today we're going to attempt to go to a new gym. It's a bodybuilding gym. I just want to check it out. There's some cool lighting. People are getting good content there, so I wanted to go check it out.
You want
to
get food?
Yeah, I'll probably get some grub.
Alright, bet.
Tacos?
Sure. I'm already full right now, but I'll stuff them in.
Oh, I'm fucking full as hell right now. I had the 1300 calorie elixir shake. The mixture of choice that I'm gonna try today is gonna be jungle juice and fruit punch glycerol. Then let me get that pomegranate juice.
Your $40 bottle of pomegranate juice?
I got the palm.
Oh, fuck it.
The old one. I was in a rush, so I just swung my Harmons and got it. Yeah, so we're gonna try this new gym. I'm getting kind of sick of my gym because it's getting motherfucking crowded. I mean, this is like a new populated area of Utah. There's a lot of people moving in over here, kind of just like I did, so. But they're all getting the same idea. They want to get gains, and they're all going to the same fucking gym, and it's kind of getting
fucked.
It's getting busy, yeah. I'm like finding myself waiting like 15 minutes per machine and stuff. I'm not really fucking with it, so. I'm gonna go try out other gyms. Maybe we'll try out a different gym even in the next video, but yeah. So we're gonna run two scoops gorilla mode for the nice juicy pump. And then we're gonna run a scoop of glycerol for that hyperhydration, baby. People ask me what glycerol does, it's just a hyperhydration product. Intramuscular hyperhydration, pretty much that meaning more water, more nutrients sent to muscle equals bigger pump, me feel good, me take pictures of myself.
Okay, dope.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Yeah, you mix that with mode, which already gives you a good pump because the glycer pump in it and all the nice nootropics and pump products in it. So ultimate stack plus a pomegranate juice, there's like a hefty fucking 80 grams of fast digesting carbs in this bad boy, so nothing but pure gains in this bottle.
Ooh, worth it.
I don't even know how to describe it. Tastes out of this world though. So people were asking about, come on Wi-Fi, come on! People are asking about the wing that I'm gonna get, or the wing that I'm getting.
Mm-hmm.
So it's with Street Hunter. One of my friends recommended them, but it's this one.
A little closer. Fuck,
it fits
bro.
The car so well. So that's gonna be a mandatory, and then I'm just gonna go with the same company for the lip. See how it makes it like thicker on the bottom?
Yeah, fuck
right
yeah.
There. So it just makes it look beefier. Looks tough as fuck. And then other than that, people were asking about like tunes and stuff. I'm planning on an E50 tune. I'm not really worried about making the car fast because I've gotten in trouble for being fast. So I'm gonna let that kind of blow over a little bit before I worry about getting fast or anything. And then other than that, I actually want to get new seats. So I want to get like some fucking sport car seats.
Yeah.
Where you got like double
some 5
over.
Points.
Yeah, some fucking serious shit. And I want them red. Because I feel like there's a lot of red going on, like red accents, so yeah, I'm gonna do that. And then for the wheels, let me show the wheels that I want. I forgot what brand they're, but see how there's like a red accent on it? It complements it so
sick.
Well.
Damn, yeah. Son.
Yeah, so that's the plan with the Supra. And then I'm gonna get the basic downpipe and a cool air intake, so it'll make the little...
Like, when do you want to have all this done by?
I'd say like a month or two, because I'm sure shipping is pretty fucking AIDS.
Facts. Russia's got shit locked in.
Yeah. But everything else is stock. Like, this bitch pops and stuff stock. Listen.
Yeah.
It's pretty nice stock. It sounds so good in the bay, because I hate cars that are obnoxious in the bay.
Yeah.
Where you're like,
oh fuck.
It's like ear raping you in the bay. On the outside, you guys have heard it in a video. It's like, it's pretty not. Growly. 24/7?
Yeah, we don't do that.
Don't do that.
No cardio.
Are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
Oh, so you're doing the kid in the world. I'm not even exaggerating.
You compete in open?
Yeah.
Nice.
Did
I sniff any MILFs lately?
Yeah.
I got a girlfriend now, dude.
Oh, that sucks.
Don't you have a girlfriend?
Long-term girlfriend.
locked in.
The breeding at this point, she's like 5'11", so I have to get my genetics up there somehow.
She's, when she wears heels, it's kind of like...
Oh yeah, she's dunking on my ass. I'm barely 5'11".
My girlfriend's like 5'4", so I'm chilling.
This is like, gyms across America should be doing this shit.
Oh,
deodorant, bro. Because motherfuckers just be forgetting.
I'll be at the cables, I'm like, yo, dog.
You really in here smelling like onions and chips and shit. I'm a fucking hairspray. You get your hair right, too.
Yo.
Big motherfucker. I need up my creatine. Probably not going to stick to program this workout. I got a back and rear delt day. I want to mess around with this new equipment because, I mean, at our other gym, we had pretty basic shit. So I'm going to try out this equipment, maybe adjust my program a little bit to the equipment we got here. This is like good advice for people who are like traveling and stuff too, who want to stick to program. So if you're doing the style that I'm doing, what I like to do is pick 3 or 4 movements for the big muscle group. So let's say you're doing back and rear delts. I'd probably pick 4 movements for back, and I'd want to split it up into horizontal and vertical pulls. So like maybe a pull up and a pull down, and then maybe a cable row and a barbell row, and then you're good. And I'd just do, for compounds, I'd just do that top failure set, 6 to 8-ish reps. And then on more accessory work, like cable rows and stuff, I'd do a top set of 6 to 8 reps to complete failure, and then a back off anywhere from 10 to 15 reps of complete failure. Just get that stimulus, and it's like the same rep schemes and stuff, just so you get the same work in. That's kind of like what I do for traveling and stuff. Same goes for like chest. You could do the same thing if it was like a chest and bicep workout. You pick 4 movements for chest, and you could do 2 of them being a fly movement and 2 of them being a press movement, and then you can just get it rolling like that. This, you guys probably saw JPG do this on TikTok if you follow him. So I love this movement just to get the lat as short as possible in the beginning when you're fresh. If you can really isolate the lat with this movement. So you want to get on one knee with it, and the knee that's down is going to be aligned with the arm that you're pulling with. Just so you can pull it in and twitch your body. I usually like to do these a little bit higher reps, so I might even do 2 sets of like the 10 to 15 rep range. You'll start from like right here, supinate the wrist a little bit, and almost dig your elbow into your back pockets, and you'll feel a really deep lat contraction with that. And another cue I like giving people is to pull with your elbow. So drive your elbow into the floor, into your back pockets, and repeat. All the way up, get a full stretch. And then all the way down, drive your elbow down, and repeat. Lat, yeah,
and then you bring it down all the way.
Dude, I didn't know that's what it's called, but that's what I do.
Telling them that it's good to get like
a full
contraction in the beginning. Yeah,
let your scapula come out and then do the full retraction.
Because later on, like after everything, all the lactic acid and your muscles being exhausted and stuff, you can't really get like a full.
Talking about, like with anatomy,
yeah.
You're just lengthening and shortening your lat. Like, because if you go too deep, then you're going to start hitting like other back exercises.
Yeah.
But in that specific movement, that's how you're getting the longest lat, like stretch, and then the hardest contraction.
So we're attacking kind of a different sort of pull. Still going vertical, so we're still going to work the lats. I just wanted to utilize this grip. I haven't used this grip before, so I'm gonna start using it. It's a pretty neutral pull down, and I feel like this is the most natural position for a stretch and contraction for the lat. Giving a good pause at the bottom, good full stretch at the top. I'm gonna be running a top set of 6 to 8 reps complete failure and a back off of 10 to 15 reps complete failure. So a little bit heavier on the first set, drop it like anywhere from 30 to 40 pounds because you won't be able to do as many reps, especially after doing that first set, so.
Oh,
like this classic Arnold T-bar row a try, run for its money. I usually do like a basic barbell row movement, but I like this because it's in more of a fixed position. It's more consistent rather than kind of like making your own bar path. It's already built in with like the axles and stuff. So I'm going to count this as my compound movement. So I'm just going to do one top set, 6 to 8 reps. It's cool to take like 2-3 warm-up sets, do as many warm-ups as you need. Just take that top set to complete failure. Most gyms might not have this. So if they don't have this, then go ahead and just go the standard T-bar row route where you put the bar, like the barbell in the corner and put the weight on top. Or some gyms have like a built-in T-bar row for you with the barbell. But yeah, top set, 6 to 8 reps, complete failure.
Can you stop? High five? High five. Good boy.
Yeah.
Good boy.
I love birds. And we used to have what are the blue ones of those, and they're so colorful?
The hyacinth or something like that. The big, big ones. Yeah. This is a scarlet Amazon macaw.
Running the 6 to 8 reps top set. Same thing as the pull down. So top set is 6 to 8, backup set 10 to 12-ish reps, both sets to failure. Don't be afraid to drop the weight. Make that shit clean. I'm doing a little pause at the contraction, and then make sure you give a slight lean forward at the bottom just to get that full stretch. You don't want to be in like a fixed movement like this, because then you're not stretching your back all the way. Like, keep your lower back straight. Your upper back can have a slight round just to get that stretch. Bring your shoulder blades back like you're pinching a pencil behind your shoulders. You should be chilling. We normally run the pec deck first. I'm gonna do pec deck after this because I like pec deck, the reverse pec deck. But we're gonna do this variation. I saw JPG do this too, and I wanna try it out. So you start it at like the highest point or close to the highest point. You're not gonna be able to do a lot of weight because this is more so just isolating the rear delt. It's a small ass muscle. So keep your arm in the same position, slight bend like this. And you just want your arm to be consistently moving like this and pull back, get that good contraction in your rear delt. Giving it a slight pause at the bottom too. And then just let it come across your body while holding the resistance in your rear delt, and just repeat. Do 2 sets of 10 to 15, kind of like the pull downs, just because I'm gonna get a lot of reps with this. Both sets going to failure though. Being natural is so ass, bro.
Get on that shit.
Bro, I want to so bad. It's only me and Alex. Me and Alex holding it down. And Lex.
And Lex.
Holding it down, Natty Kings. So tempting, bro. You put in all the work, and it's just so slow. You gain like 3 pounds of muscle a year. One of these days, I'm just gonna plateau, and I'm not gonna have fun in the gym. And I'll be like, all right. Well, it's either I keep going to the gym and not seeing progress, or
crank time.
Yeah, time to go fucking Anakin on him. All right, finishing up, this will be the last movement. Some good old pec deck rear delt flies. Right, same thing, 10 to 15 reps, 2 sets, finish things off, complete failure. Did a good pause at the back. Just try to isolate that rear delt. You'll get some trap activation, but just try to isolate best possible. Finish off that back, baby. Jesus. All right, so maybe like 9 or 10 videos back, I came here to try the birria tacos, like the tacos where you dip them in the red sauce and stuff, because I wanted to try them, and then it's at this place. So I'm gonna put my cameraman Dylan on it.
Oh, you already know.
Just because I haven't witnessed anyone else experience it, and I just want the satisfactory of seeing someone else try the best Mexican food they've ever had.
Oh, shit. Oh my god, what is that? Is this even legal?
Wow. I'm going in for another order for to go.
Oh yeah. Dude, I'm drooling. Phil, give me.
Again, is it for two?
Yeah. Ready?
Yes.
Oh yeah.
Tastes like home. Yo, words can't describe what's going on in my mouth right now.
Pure bliss.
I think I'm getting a boner, frankly. If you're ever at Taco Gallo Loco in Utah, it's in Sandy, fucking come here. The quality of my life just significantly increased from eating that, like my serotonin levels.
Dude, that was the most euphoric I've ever gotten with food.
Oh.